President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. is speaking at the founding anniversary of the Department of Social Welfare and Development. Let's listen.
Government, other distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It is a great pleasure and honor to join you today in celebrating the 72nd anniversary of the Department of Social Welfare and Development and the inauguration and ceremonial turnover of your new multi-purpose building. I would like to begin by acknowledging the presence of Attorney Mans here in this event, the DSWD officer in charge at Punay, and all the officials and employees of this extremely important department. Today, we recognize and take pride in this institution's stability and reliability. For over 70 years, the DSWD has remained unwavering in your mission to improve the lives of every Filipino, especially those who are in distress, those who are in danger, and those who we can see are disadvantaged. In fact, your dedication has proven vital to the success of this noble institution and this noble work that you do for our people. And that is why I join the entire Filipino people in expressing our gratitude for your continued excellence in rendering public service. Alam ko na kung minsan ang pakiramdam ninyo dahil kayo ay kung nasaan pinapapunta, na malalayo, na hindi kinikilala ang inyong trabaho, huwag niyo pong isipin yun. Kinikilala at nagpapasalamat ang madlang Pilipino sa inyong mga ginagawa. And although we do not do it often enough, I must remind you today that you have been, especially in the pandemic, that the DSWD has been the lifeline for millions and millions of Filipino. Ang dami ninyong sa inyong sipag, sa inyong trabaho, ang dami ninyong natulungan. Kung hindi sa tulong ng DSWD, kung hindi sa ating mga ibinigay na tupad, na AIX, na hanggang ngayon ay binibigay pa rin natin, yung 4Ps, kung hindi dyan, ay marami siguro sa ating mga kababayan ang nasawi ng pandemya. Kaya huwag nyo pong iisipin na kahit kayo ay ginagawa lang ninyo ang trabaho ninyo, at kung minsan ay ang pakiramdam ninyo ay walang nakakakita sa inyong ginagawa, kahit walang nakakakita sa inyong nagagawa, nararamdaman ng lahat ang inyong trabaho, ang inyong tulong at ang inyong sakripisyo. Maraming salamat sa inyo. Through your efforts and sacrifices, we have made inroads in reducing poverty, in reducing hunger, and towards achieving upper middle income status by 2025. Maliwanag din sa akin that these same efforts and sacrifices are driven by two things: your faithfulness to service and a true, genuine love for the Filipino people. Most important qualities that we need in the social programs of our government. I know this because I have witnessed you working long hours, making many sacrifices, even risking life and limb to give our people the service that they need and that they deserve, especially the vulnerable and the disadvantaged. For all of this, you deserve not only our gratitude, but also our highest esteem and deepest appreciation. With the latest developments that we welcome in your department, I'm confident we can further boost the skills, provide you with multiple opportunities to promote your professional growth, and strengthen your roles as public servants. With this new multi-purpose building that we inaugurate today, we will lay the foundations of a competent and dynamic DSWD by providing a venue for employee welfare and wellness programs. The inauguration of this structure underscores the department's commitment to ensure that the occupational health and safety, as well as the general welfare of DSWD employees, are put into the fore. As we look to the future, I enjoin the DSWD once again and all government agencies to ensure that your services reach those in need wherever they may be. People should not need to travel to urban areas to access government services. That is why we must ensure that everyone, everywhere, will have access to all the help and services that they need. Continue calibrating the Pantawid Pamilyang Pilipina program and strengthening the government's social protection initiatives, especially since one of the measures we undertake to address poverty is through the grants that we provide for the health needs of every household and education of our children. In addition to this, I call upon the department to continue to implement the unconditional cash transfer program to provide cash grants to poor households and individuals who do not benefit from the lower income tax rates but who are adversely affected by rising prices. Let us also enhance the social pension program for indigent senior citizens as a means to augment their daily subsistence and medical needs. And finally, I encourage the DSWD once again, remain steadfast in your commitment to ensuring that more Filipinos will be provided with quality service in the coming years. The work that you do is crucial, and I am assured that with your dedication and hard work, we will continue to make the progress in uplifting the lives of our fellow Filipinos. With you leading the charge in our government's social programs, I am confident that we can build a more inclusive and compassionate society that truly cares and respects the life of every single Filipino. Congratulations once again to the DSWD on your 72nd anniversary. You will always remain a shining example of efficient, compassionate, and selfless service to us all in government. Maraming salamat at mabuhay po kayong lahat. Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat.
Thank you very much, Ms.
We have just witnessed President Marcos speaking on the 72nd anniversary of DSWD. President Marcos commends the efforts of the department, saying they are the lifeline of millions of Filipino people. The DSWD's faithfulness to service and genuine love for the people is the driving force of the agency. Marcos promises DSWD's services reach those who are in need, promising to provide access for every Filipino. He calls for the enhancement of DSWD's various programs, mentioning cash grants for those in need, assistance for the elderly, and strengthening social programs to enhance the lives of the Filipinos. They are the shining example of compassionate service to Pinoys by the government.